Everyone, welcome you back for the session on the fiber optics. See, the term fiber optics, it consists of the two things. One is with respect to the fiber, the another one is the optics. Optics is with respect to the study of the light. The fiber is nothing but a cable, or it may be a glass fiber where the diameter is of very less. The optical fiber conducts the light in which the same way as that of a copper wire conducts the electricity. The most common use of the optic fiber or the fiber optics is in the transmission of the materials, or it may be the signals in the case of the telephone, or it may be in the case of the TVs, or even with respect to the numerical data for a longer distance. Nowadays, optical fiber is having a major application with respect to the transmission of the data from one continent to another continent through the internet. The data transmission takes place using the light instead of electricity. In the context of the smart structure, the role of the optical fiber, or it may be the fiber optics, is different and is in the form of the sensing the physical parameters such as the strain, temperature, pressures, and as well as the vibrations in the structural components. See, this is having a major application with respect to the mechanical industries. As you know that the fibers can be embedded inside the structures, and the deformation characteristics of the structures can be measured very easily. Now, in the design of the complex structural components such as the jet engines, fans, blades, much analysis or the static testing can conduct to estimate the suitable point and as well as the suitable deformation, what it is taking place at the high speeds, that it can be analyzed very easily by using the strain gauges. The complexity of the mode can be such that these suitable point may be in fact the miss some critical strain locations. By embedding the grid of the fibers, a more thorough strain mapping can be obtained than it is possible via discrete strain gauges located at the surface of the structures. The schematic diagram shows the fiber optics, or it may be the cable which is used to transmit the signals. This fiber optics are the fibers which consists of the four different layers. The first one is nothing but the core, the second one is nothing but the cladding, the third one is nothing but the coating, and the fourth one is nothing but the strength member, and the last one is nothing but the outer jacket. See, these depends upon the type of the application, where and what we are using. In general, the fibers, it may be consists of the three layers, the primary coat and as well as the secondary coat, and the inner one is nothing but the optical fiber. These optical fiber are having a major applications in the transmitting the data from one continent to another continent. The total internal reflection, the basic principle governing the operation of the fiber optics in application, is the total internal reflection, which can occur when the light wave traveling in one medium encounters to another medium. Example is the light traveling in air encountering a surface of the water, because the refractive index of the water and the air is totally different. The light waves behaves differently at the interface. By considering the media 1 and as well as the media 2, the refractive index is N1, and the light wave entering to the media 1 encounters another medium, a refractive index of N2. N2 is always less than N1. With this, the schematic diagram shows the internal reflection is taking place with respect to the angle. See, this is the basic things what we have discussed and what we have studied in the earlier in the lower primary schools only. Now, the theta 1 is greater than theta 2. The ray of the light is reflected back entirely into the medium 1, which is represented the condition of the total internal reflection with a no loss in the transmission. This concept or this phenomenon is adopted in the case of the optical fiber. They also obey the law of reflection or the Snell's law, which states that the ray undergoes a refraction when it propagates from one medium to the another medium, such as that the ratio of the sine of the incidence angle and the sine of the refracted angle is equal to the ratio of the reciprocal of the refractive index of the media, that is nothing but sine theta 1 by sine theta 2 is equal to n2 by n1. See, this is a basic principle which is adopted in the case of the optical fibers, or it may be in the case of the fiber optics, which is suggested that the total internal reflection can occur only when the light wave traveling in a medium with a certain index attempts to move into another medium with a lower refractive index. The numerical aperture. The relationship between the incidence angle theta I and as well as the indices and the refraction may be derived for the condition of the total internal reflection, which is as shown in the figure. This is a schematic diagram which shows where the total internal reflection is taking place inside the optical fiber. Now this is where sine theta 1 by sine theta 2 is equal to n1 by n2, or sine theta I is equal to n1 by n0 into sine theta r, where the right angle triangle theta r is equal to sine 90 degree minus of phi, which is equal to cos phi, that it can be represented as sine theta I is equal to n1 by n0 is equal to cos of phi. Then sine theta max is equal to n1 by n0 is equal to cos phi c. By applying the Snell's law, we get the entire equation, the theta max is equal to sine inverse of root of n1 squared minus n2 squared. What is the numerical aperture of the optical fiber? See, as per the definition, the measurement of the optical fiber ability to collect the occurrence light ray in it is known as the numerical aperture. In the short form, the numerical aperture that illustration the efficiency with the light which collects within the fiber and gets the same propagated. We know that when the light is propagated through the optical fiber during the total internal reflection, so the multiple total internal reflection takes place within the fiber to transmit from one end to the another end. Once the light ray is produced from the source of the optical fiber, then the optical fiber should be very efficient to get the maximum emitted radiation in it. So we can say that efficiency of the light which is getting from the optical fiber is the main character once transmitting the signal throughout the optical fiber.